Please welcome to the stage your host of Theatre Corner, Michael Taylor.
Welcome to Theatre Corner. I'm your host, Michael Taylor. Theatre Corner is an interview series dedicated to promoting diversity and inclusion throughout the national theater scene. Tonight, we're filming in front of a live audience made up of theater students at the California Center for the Arts in Escondido, California. So, silence your cell phones, folks. You're entering Theater Corner. Our next guest is an actor, professor, writer, Kathryn Smith-McGlynn. Let's take a look at her work.
Okay, close your eyes. Close your eyes and keep them closed.
Okay.
I was gonna wait to see if we ever made it to Inverness, but okay, open them. Open your eyes. Margaret, will you search for the huge unknown thing out there waiting for you with me for the rest of our lives? Oh my God, I'm... If you say you are so flattered.
No, I say yes, I say yes.
Yeah. I say yes.
Yes.
Very good. Kathryn Smith-McGlynn. Please, let's welcome her to the stage. Kathryn, I just read off the many tasks that you maintain. So tell me about the main thing. Perhaps acting?
Yes, acting. Acting has been the through line. You know, I mean, life is not linear, right?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, acting for me, oh gosh, my first role was I was 10 years old on Polly in The Adventures of Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn. So I've been doing it for a long time, professionally since I was 21, right after undergrad.
At one time, you were a puppeteer. Tell me about this experience as a puppeteer.
I was. That was my...
Basically, you've done it all.
I've done it all. It's not linear, Michael. It's not right, linear. Right. Right after undergrad, go blue, Wolverines. Right after I graduated, it was my first professional gig, and it was as a puppeteer. And hand and rod puppets, body puppets. I learned how to use the puppets in a way that is true to the puppet. You talk about truth, you know. It's a skill, you know. It's a skill, not only embodying the character of the puppet, but just making sure that the puppet's mouth is speaking the way that a person would speak. You know, you open up on the vowels and everything. It's an art. It was great. I performed in, that was in Cincinnati, Ohio.
Is that something that enhanced your acting?
Yes, I think so. It helped me be more adept at formulating characters.
Mm.
You know? I mean, if you can put voice to something furry that's sitting on your hand and make it real, then it can only enhance, you know?
At what point did you start the theater company?
Frontera Rep. I started that theater company in, I want to say, 2012. When I started my family, my husband and I, our son Aiden came into the world. We were living in New York.
Hmm.
And we were, you know, changing baby diapers on the subway, and, you know, on the, you know, we're, you know, trying to, oh, get off at the next stop, and you're like, right, changing diapers. And we said, okay, this has got to be a better way. We can't do this right now. So we ended up moving to El Paso, Texas, from New York City, which is right in the middle of the desert,
right,
a beautiful town. And here I am, and I was committed to being a stay-at-home mom, and that lasted for a couple of months until I thought, I got to do something, you know? And so I was looking around for what can I do here? And I found that there was a need for theater arts there. And there's the University of Texas has a branch there, and I began teaching there at UTEP, which is a great school, and actually formed a collaboration with the theater and dance department there, whereby my theater company employed not only professional actors, but also served as a conduit for the candidates, the bachelor candidates in the program that were able to apprentice with, along with professionals. And there was not a professional equity theater company within hundreds of miles there. I was able to really add to the economic landscape there, the cultural landscape there. And the desert really is a beautiful place. It really is a beautiful place. And El Paso has my heart.
Tell me about your advice of creating where you are.
Yes, well, I think about New York, Hollywood, Chicago. I cut my teeth first. Of course, I went to Cincinnati, and then I went to Chicago, you know, and I was there. I came out to L.A. for a bit. I went to New York. You know, I was in D.C. I feel that you don't have to have that destination. I have to go to this place in order to make it. You know, I've got to go to the Great White Way. I've got to go to Broadway. I've got to be on Broadway, you know, or I've got to go to L.A. My advice for anyone, really, that wants to be an artist, an actor, or any type of theater artist or visual art, performing art, is be where you are.
There you go.
Be where you are. There is great art happening in these small enclaves, these small cities and communities. And anyone that you see out there, that whether it's Lynn Nottage, you know, you've got Nambi Kelly out there, all of these great playwrights and artists that are making great work, they started out where they were. You know, and you know, contribute to your community, and from there, you will start here, and from there, it will just reverberate exponentially, you know, and yes, that may take you to New York City, yeah. You know, it may take you to Hollywood, you know, or you may end up staying where you are, and then going out to those places. That can be your center. But I think everyone needs a theater home to call theirs. And I'm lucky enough to call several places.
So I'd love to hit you with the advice you'd give to your 18-year-old self. Because I think I think you have an interesting answer.
Okay, 18. Because 18 is what? You're graduating from high school. If you choose to go to university, you may be a freshman. And I remember that very vividly. And I would say, if there are any doors that you would like to open, go ahead and open them. You know? It doesn't have to be one.
Right.
No, it's a time for exploration and discovery. Right? I think all your life is. But there were doors that I wish I would have opened.
Oh, I see.
You know, that I was like, should I knock? I was like, you know what? I'm doing this door over here, so I'm going to go over here. You know, and I wish I would have gone back and just said, okay. I just knocked on that door.
And then let's take it 10 years forward. And is that advice the same to the 28-year-old you?
Well, I think that's a through line, absolutely. You know, you have to remember the advice you give to yourself. You know, it doesn't, you add on to it. You don't change it. You add on to it, right? So I would say my 28-year-old self, trust in the fact that you know what you know. You know what you know. You know, you've been out there for a while, and, you know, you're always going to run into forces that are going to say, you know, I mean, there's a lot of rejection in this business. There's a lot of rejection in life.
Right.
Okay? And you can be made to think, well, gosh, what's wrong? I'm not good enough. Okay. All right, let me go over here and do this, and then I'll come back and I'll be good enough. Yeah. Not good enough? Oh, okay. Well, okay, let me go over here, and then I'll get this piece of paper, and I'll come back, and then I'll be good enough. Okay, I'll get this experience, and then I'll be good enough. And then you realize, wait a minute, what's going on here? You know, doors that you feel should be flying open for you that may not, you know, and you might question yourself, question your abilities, you know. And then you realize as you meander a little bit older into your 30s, you go, wait a second, I knew what I knew.
Right.
You know? What? You know, and so there's so many of us walking around. We're overeducated. We're overexperienced. Because we're trying to prove, yeah, I'm good enough. I'm good enough, right? Oh, wait, I'm. You know, but I love that the new generation, the millennials, are coming up, and they're just like, yeah, I'm an expert. Yes, I am. You know, so you have to trust that you know what you know. So just keep moving forward.
Right.
Yeah.
Tell me about your experience on Grey's Anatomy. I mean, that's a long-running show. Debbie Allen directing.
Let me tell you, I have a story about that. I met Shonda Rhimes before Shonda Rhimes was Shonda Rhimes.
Oh, okay.
I did. I mean, every actor has a story, right?
Yeah.
Where they auditioned for something and didn't get it. That was mine. I auditioned for the role of Meredith Grey. Well, that's the side that they gave me, the copy. And it took me a while to remember, like, and that was Shonda. Shonda Rhimes, I met Shonda Rhimes. I was in her office and I auditioned for, oh my goodness, you know. And I got a call back and everything. I was not Meredith Grey. I did not get that role. But fast forward, I was called in for actually a really great episode because it was they call it the J-April, April and Jackson and April, and they were getting divorced. Yeah, they call him J-April. April, get it, J-April. I played April's lawyer in that episode, and it was great. I mean, it's, you know, sometimes you come onto a set of a long-running series like that, you know, the wheels are already turning.
Right,
you know,
right.
It's a machine. It's well-oiled, you know. And what I loved about it was just so, they were all so welcoming. Jesse Williams, you know, and no one looked down on you because you were down here on the call sheet,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, yeah.
It was, oh, welcome, you know, fellow artists, you know, come on in, you know. And, yeah, that was a really great experience.
Very good.
Yeah.
Let's open it up for questions for Kathryn.
Hi, Kathryn.
Hi.
Thank you for your advice about being unafraid to open doors. Now I'm curious, what's the best advice someone ever gave you?
I would say my mom, Dorothy. Her best advice to me was that I'm enough. You know? You know, I have a tendency to try to over, you know, give and, you know, and she reminds me always that I'm enough, just who I am, you know. But Mom, do I need to straighten my hair? Do I need to, you know, maybe I need to change my image. What do I need to do to be able to, you know, be over there? And she's like, Kathryn, you're enough, honey. Just be you.
I love that.
Very good. Thank you so much for coming to Theater Corner.
Thank you for having me.
And enhancing the set. So we'll be watching you in your theater journey.
Yes.
And really appreciate you. And Kathryn, thank you so much. Thank you for joining us for another episode of Theater Corner, and we'll see you next time.